The Midwives, accompanied by leaders and residents, celebrated the Midwives Day at Uphill Hotel in Kagadi District under the theme Together Again, From Evidence to Reality.
Chosen by God.
Chosen by God.
Josephine Nabakoza, the Kagadi Hospital Principal Nursing Officer, pointed out a number of challenges affecting service delivery at Kagadi Hospital. Nabakoza explains that the maternity sets required to conduct safe delivery are not available, and this puts the lives of midwives, mothers and newborns at risk of infection.
The sets which are contained to conduct the delivery, we don't have. So you find the midwife, she's at risk, the risk to the mother and the risk to the what? To the midwife herself. Because everything we are trying to use, we are improvising. You find you are giving an episiotomy with a razor blade. We don't have even episiotomy scissor or what is contained in that delivery set.
In the past 2 months, 7 mothers have died while giving birth at Kagadi Hospital, whereas 24 neonates have died due to lack of equipment and care. A number of challenges have been highlighted.
The midwife may not have some equipment or logistics to use or some samples. Then they can say, can you go and buy cotton in the pharmacy? Can you go and buy this in the pharmacy? So all those movements of the caregiver to go and buy this and that also contributes to delays.
You find that, yes, they are delayed in the communities, they are delayed, but also when we come to the facilities because of unfavorable conditions.
Old boys of Kagadi People's Secondary School also took part in the celebrations. The association, chaired by Dr. Frank Kabuye of Makerere University Business School, appreciated midwives for their efforts to save lives.
One of the things we heard from the midwives, they are trying so that there is always less motivation. They are always less cared for. They are not hurt. Then we realized, as old boys and girls of Kagadi People's Secondary School, we need to mobilize them. We need to look for the stakeholders and work together. And together with them, we had to mobilize this day as a way of sharing experience, as a way of motivating each other, and as a way of encouraging them.
Gaps have also been pointed out in skilling midwifery manpower.
That when we equip our midwives with theory, they will end up in the skills lab to practice on the assimilation, to deliver these babies before they go to the live living mothers. They have to first practice.
Because we want hands-on. But sometimes you find we don't have enough equipment to use. Like sometimes if we have like obstetric emergencies, yes, we may be involved, but not as such.
Benjamin Tumsime, the Kagadi Deputy Resident District Commissioner, tasked midwives to carry out sensitization on the dangers of early pregnancies.
These things are prevented. If we can go back and do the needful, I would appreciate you the more. You have saved lives. You have helped mothers, you have helped young ones, the population has grown, and the country is proud of your midwives.
Kagadi General Hospital was built to hold a capacity of 100 inpatients in 1969, but this facility receives over 20 expectant mothers on a daily basis, something that prompts women to sleep on the mats and mattresses spread on the floor while waiting for midwives and nurses. Some share the limited space with their newborn babies. Story by Thomas Tumwebaze for the news in Kagadi.